I am very much thankful to Mangal sir, Jairam Jagyeshan and Amit Ajgaonkar. They have invited me here to deliver and share some of my cases of fracture neck of the femur. So, a senior in your country, a very high incidence of delayed presentation, neglected fracture and failed internal fixation. The inadequate bone stock is the problem in non-union, impaired vascularity, difficult reduction, inadequate fixation, and how to treat these fractures. It is a surgeon's problem because we get many cases, young patient, where replacement is not the solution. So dilemma is preserve the femoral head or replace. So before you plan the treatment, please consider need and disparity. On the left side, I am treating this patient. On the right side, those who are sitting here in the hall, they are treating the patients. Therefore, the treatment may be varied between whether left side or on the right side. So Dr. Desai is there. He is up right side, I am up the left side. But 27 days old injury in a 56-year-old male farmer, Powell's type 3 with a void in the posterior medial part of the neck. What are the treatment options? Treatment options may be, in this modern era, may be a replacement, but you can also try this method by osteosynthesis. Now this is one of the paper we published, DHS osteosynthesis with internal bone grafting in unstable delayed presented intracapsular fracture neck of the femur in the August issue of 2017. So the objective of this surgery, augment with bone graft to improve the hole. That hole inside the fracture neck of the femur, it should be filled up, graft packed all around north, south, east, and west of the guide wire. Fill this void to avoid inevitable second surgery. And you can say this is the fracture treated by the internal bone grafting through the hole of the DHS triple rimmer. Healed after internal bone grafting through DHS hole with a fixation by DHS. And this is the 3 years follow-up. Though the Powell's angle has not changed. Powell's angle still remains, it is 3. Another example, a 1-month-old fracture with resorption of neck in a 40-year male, Powell's type 3 with the void in the posterior superior part of the neck. Option is a stepwise procedure of internal bone grafting. And you can see close reduction with a temporary wire fixation to prevent loss of fixation. Because mostly in a non-united and when there is a neck gap, there is always a retroversion after you do a close reduction. So that we have to found because there is a posterior loss. And then stepwise procedure, internal bone grafting, DHS osteosynthesis, and the procedure is complete. So I will share innumerable examples. This is a 6 weeks old fracture, 32-year female, with a resorption of the femoral neck, and you can see a shortening of the neck on how to treat this patient, fixation with the internal bone graft, and you can see a complete restoration of the anatomy and full function, 1 year follow-up, 2 year follow-ups, and 3 years follow-up. Another example, a 10 days old fracture with a vertical fracture line, a complete restoration of the function, no need of a change of a Powell's angle 3, and the fracture united perfectly, minimal invasive treatment of these cases. So osteosynthesis with DHS and primary cancellous bone grafting, simple, easy to perform procedure, biological treatment for early union to prevent further potential complications of non-union avascular necrosis, and failure in a particular case can be treated with any appropriate second procedure because we have not violated the anatomy of the proximal femur if it fails. another. I will go step by step from simple cases to difficult cases. And this is the Powell concept of fracture healing. Change of fracture line from vertical to horizontal by osteotomy will usually result in healing. That concept is given way back in 1935 and still it holds to after even 100 years. So my dear friends, what is this? This is the concept where if you change the angle from 3 to at least 2 to 1, probably the conversion of a shearing to compression forces will heal the fracture. So this is the example, fixation of neck by DHS in a 40-year male, high Powell's angle, fixed with DHS through migration and loss of fixation. Because the angle was not corrected, Powell 3 angle, what to do? Correct the angulation and translation and fix with DHS with additional screw, and you do a osteotomy at the level of the intertrochanteric, change the angle and it will heal. This is how a fixation is revised with abduction osteotomy, DHS fixation, and union of osteotomy and fracture 2 years follow-up without violating the proximal femoral anatomy. But mind you, this is not the Powell's osteotomy. This is a modified Powell's osteotomy. Powell's osteotomy gives medialization of the shaft, which is very detrimental for the future surgery of joint replacement. Therefore, the osteotomy, it is a modified Powell's osteotomy. Another example, there are two examples. 1 month old fracture in a 56 old, now it's a 10 years follow-up. Complete restoration of the anatomy by a abduction osteotomy. Another example, a 6-week-old fracture neck femur, and you can see here in a 50-year-old male, a complete restoration of anatomy, and this is 3 years follow-up. Another example, a 1 month-old fracture in a 22-year-old male, Powell's type 3 with a displacement garden 4, you can say, and 10 years follow-up. You can see that you cannot just recognize which fracture was fractured, complete restoration, and 10 years follow-up. Another example, a 35-day-old fracture neck femur in a 52-year-old male, Powell's try garden 4 combination, especially posterior medial, and it is a 52 years old. You can replace it by anything cemented or non-cemented bipolar, anything you can give. You can reduce the morbidity and you can provide his own hip joint by doing the osteotomy, and 4 years follow-up, a modified Powell's valgus osteotomy, a full function in a 50-year-old teacher. So another example, a non-united fracture in a 57 years old after CC screw fixation, and you can see that how it is nicely done with a DHS, derotation screw, abduction osteotomy, modified lateralization of the shaft, no disturbance of anatomy of proximal femur, and you can see the fracture has united, 3 years follow-up, able to sit and squat. And this is how it is required for our country and village poor patients. So non-union and late presentation cases, DHS with abduction osteotomy, good and encouraging results, predictable outcome, rate of failure is reduced. You have to just, from 3 to 2, 2 to 1, we have to just correct the angle, not 30 to 40, because it creates a problem for proximal femur. Just give a 220 to 25 angle is remove, and they will restore the anatomy. Again, this is the example, common problem in rural area. This is how we are getting the patients. Because neglected fracture, delayed presentation, the surgery is not performed good, because how can you say that it is the surgical technique or what? And there are so many wrong application of the principles of surgery in young patient. And these are all disaster outcome which are in the gallery of my mobile. So young patient with a delayed presentation, neglected fracture, implant failure, displacement and resorption is the common problem, challenge to save the femoral head or replace. Majority will be, they are applying that they replace it, but we will reconstruct. So, a valgus intertrochanteric osteotomy and fibular strut grafting in the management of neglected femoral fracture. This is the article which is way back published in 2013. Sir, welcome, sir. Good morning. So, this is how it is. We have to reconstruct. How it is to be reconstruct? Surgery on a fracture table with an image intensifier. Close reduction of a fracture. No, believe on me. Majority of the non-united neglected fracture can be reduced on fracture table. Very few patients may require a open reduction. It is an inhibition. It is a surgeon's inhibition that it will not be reduced. You try, will be reduced with various maneuvers. Stabilization of the fractures by two guide wires. Plan low guide wire in AP and center of the head in the lateral, because we want to do a osteotomy and bone graft. So another, DHS, I don't use a condylar breast plate. I think it's a very difficult surgery for me, but a simple surgery of DHS I can perform. It allows simultaneous fixation of both fracture and osteotomy in a desired level. So technical point, how to find a true Powell's angle or shear angle? Now Powell's angles or shear angle is not measured on the X-ray which you get. It should be on the reduction of the fracture. How can you say that the Powell's angle is always 3 or 4 or displaced fracture? It is not there, you just do not need to calculate when you get the patient in AP, in OPD. It should be calculated on the fracture table when you reduce the fracture, whether it is a type 3, type 2, or type 1. That is how it is. And then remove a very small wedge. Don't remove more than 25 or 30, otherwise it will create a problem, lurching gait, and there will be a problem of gait as well as the proximal femoral anatomy is disturbed. There will be a small osteotomy wedge is enough. So this is how it is done. Stabilization by the K-wire, then DHS, then do a osteotomy, and then remove the guide wire. And through that trap, you put the fibular graft. So this is how it is. A small fibula is removed from the anterolateral part, not a complete fibula, so that the raw bleeding surface should be go inside the neck as well as in the head. So this is how a 20, and now I will show you the cases. This is how the 27-year-old females with 9-month-old neglected fracture, MRI was done, does not show the signs of AVN. So what is this? A complete absorption of the neck, shortening, overriding, and then you can see on traction table, there was a fairly good reduction. Now you can see that the angle is more than 70 or 75. So what has done? This is the same procedure. The fibular graft, derotation screw, DHS, and osteotomy. And believe me, this is the removal of implant, 3-year follow-up, full function. Disadvantage, this is the Powell's osteotomy. This is the disadvantage. Develop changes of arthritis in due course of time, that is return and middle lesser. But I have not seen more than 42 cases till date I have done. But they have not come for knee pain, they are walking, but it is written in literature, therefore I have to quote here. So, another example, a 21-year-old female, 1-year-old neglected fracture neck of the femur walking on the crutches. So what is the solution with you people? Is there any solution? Is there any solution? Yes, there is a solution, and you can see here, fixation. Skeletal traction was given for near 10 to 15 days to loosen out the thing, bring back the head of the femur, this trochanter, and you can see this is the follow-up, 2 years follow-up, everything healed around the DHS screw and the fibula, and she's a beautiful girl, she's sitting like this. But after 3 years, what has happened? After follow-up, AVN was there and there was a pain. So I thought, why not to remove this and put another cancellocortical graft of iliac crest graft. So I removed this, put some corticolocancellar graft through that tract again, and believe me, 11 years follow-up. She is a PSC nurse. She is doing all his job. And still, though it looks a horrible X-ray, she is working. May continue for another 10 years, and probably you see may require a joint replacement. Another examples: a 50-year-old male, fracture neck, femur, privately, what should be done? Because it's a day one surgery failure, it is fixed in the virus, and there is a superior migration of the neck. And I can see here, after 1 month and second month, it is everything hollow around the DHS screw. So it is a 50-year straightway solution is a joint replacement. But you can reconstruct, and you can see here, fixation, osteotomy, fibular graft, cancellous graft, combo method. The screw holes, they are packed with the bone graft, and you can see a wonderful result. And 5 years post-op, you just cannot recognize whether this patient is suffering from old fracture neck of the femur. Another examples. This is how it is. It is a hip spike by our osteopath. They are treated like this. This was an undisplaced fracture came to me. This is my case. I advised him surgery. He said, "Sahab, ye to chalta firta hai, kuch fracture mein bhi dikhta nahi x-ray mein. Why you want to do a surgery on me?" Went to the osteopath. This is the hip spike. Came after 6 weeks. And this is how the x-ray. You can see here, 6 weeks with absorption of the neck, shortening, comminution, because he was walking on it with the crutches, with the stick. And you can say abduction, osteotomy, fibular graft, 1 year follow-up. And I traced him yesterday only. This is the 10 years follow-up. He is able to sit and scat, and you just cannot recognize that the fracture was near about a 6 weeks old. This is how. There are innumerable cases. I can share, because for Mangal had said, you share only 4 or 5 cases. Therefore, so there's 62-year-old with 3 months old, 1 year follow-up, open with abduction osteotomy with fibular graft, and 5 years follow-up, near normal function, complete incorporation of the fibular graft, and remodeling of the proximal femur. So fibula is a wonder stick. Stibula, that Tanna sir said, fibula is a wonder stick. You try and fill up the gap, and you will get the results. So another example. 6 month old with absorption of the neck completely, and you can see a 15 years follow-up. You just cannot recognize there is some problem for sitting, because after doing osteotomy and this hip surgery, they have some problem of rotation. Otherwise, they are able to sit and squat comfortably. And what is needed for the toilet, for Indian toilet? Because what happened, even there is a avascular necrosis, they get a rocker bottom like of a head. And therefore, it is very easy to sit them. And I will show you the number of x-ray, how they behave even after doing a avascular necrosis. So failed fixation, osteotomy with the fibular graft, and this is the 22 years follow-up. And this patient died last year with this implant on. Now, this is the first case which I did, and you can see that is espinel with McLaughlin plate, because that time, this type of implants were not available with me, and I used to do a DHS surgery that time with espinel and McLaughlin. This is the perfect surgery, and on this surgery, I get stimulation and did number of cases. So my dear friend, this is another x-ray, 34-year-old male, 2 months old fracture with neck resorption, 3 months, 6 months, 36 months, and you can see there is avascular necrosis. No problem in sweating, 4 year follow-up with avascular necrosis, and now there is a 10 years follow-up with avascular removal of implant, packing that the screw hole with the corticulocancellogram, only difficulty in cross leg, otherwise patient is continuing. So 9 months, there are so many cases, 1 month old fracture, pivot type, the 55 year old, and this is the osteotomy was done. And this is the x-ray in the January, 10 years follow-up. There is a full function. And you can see complete resorption of the fibula and remodeling of the osteotomy side. So another, this is the very interesting case. Failed osteosynthesis, 1 year old, 53. You can see here how there is a distraction. The surgery was not done properly or what, I don't know. And this is how it is. There is sclerotic end. and it is a 53, probably the joint replacement is a worthwhile with this scenario. And you can see osteotomy, fibular grafting and fixation, a complete restoration of anatomy, and for some there is a difficulty. So my dear friends, fixation by DHS or double angle modified DHS achieves compression and stable fixation at the fracture site as well as at the site of osteotomy. Abduction osteotomy 15 to 20 degree changes the shearing stress to compression and prevents excessive rotation of the head and does not deapardite the vascular network. It restores length and does not disturb the anatomy of the proximal femur. And if at all there is a vascular necrosis, now you are all a joint replacement surgeon with modern amenities, you can go ahead with this a joint replacement. So for give a trial, don't do a joint replacement surgery in any non-united neglected fracture. Give a trial, that is the message. And failed osteotomy did not encounter any major difficulty during the conversion to THR. Done for the failed osteotomy with the lack of time, but I would have shown you how the avascular necrosis and non-united, even after the osteotomy, that can be converted into the hip joint. I have some cases, but at some time. So my dear friends, thank you very much for your patience here.
Thank you. आपका बंबई वालों के बारे में कोई गैर समझ है? हम लोग भी फ्रैक्चर फिक्स करते हैं. We don't replace all fracture neck of femurs. But I will start with a question for you, and that is, you showed us some fractures, you know, late presentation where you did internal bone grafting.
Yes.
Some you showed us same kind of interval where you did a valgus osteotomy. One. And some you showed us where you do a fibular graft. How do you differentiate? Now a patient has come to you 1 month down the line. What helps you to choose that for this one I will do internal, for this one I will do fibula, for this one I will do only abduction osteotomy?
Very good question. Actually, when you get a delayed presence or neglected fracture, the calcar is a very strong structure, the surface area. The osteolysis or cavitation forms in the center. After a traction view, if you are able to find that there is a calcar, it is hitching against the head, and there is only a bone dissolution in the center, so that in that case there is no shortening effect, maybe 4 or 5 mm. In that case, we have to pack the cavity with the bone graft. And that is an indication for the bone grafting. You have a 3 Powell's angle, but the bone quality is good. You are able to reduce it properly. But you think that it is a 15 days old, 3 weight old, some osteo-inductive problems will be there. In that case, and there is always a posterior, because if it is a neglected, then it is a posterior comminution, which is only revealed, not in the X-ray, even in the lateral, but it is in the CT scan. So in that case, we have to fill up the gap so that you have to give us some support. Otherwise, what will happen? Your fixation will fail because already the old is there. There is some osteoporosis, grip is less, and what will happen? There will be some migration and there will be a retroversion. The failure is only because of, early failure is because of the bone wants to fill up the gap. Bone wants to come together because of our DHS screw. And therefore, it is better to fill up the gap. If there is a shortening, the Sandhu's classification is very good. A Sandhu's 1, I will still go for bone grafting. 2, when there is a sclerosis, there is a shortening, there is a gap, and there is a enough bone to keep the DHS screw, then I will do a osteotomy. If I think that the more than 3 months, there is some absorption, there is some problem, and I need some structural support, then I will do a fibular graft as well as a cortical cancellous graft, so that it fibular strut will help in stabilization as well as in due course of time, a osteoinduction, incorporation after. It is not an immediate effect of the fibula. Fibula one, may two, three, help four, in five. Osteoinduction after 6 months or 9.
Yeah. You can.
You said that these abduction osteotomies heal in compression. Once the patient walks, probably it can. But if you put a fibula inside, how will it allow compression over there?
It is in the tract. There is no fixation like this. So it is in the tract. It is in the tract. We are not jam. We are just pushing it inside. The fibula is pushed inside. So there is a space is there already because the hole is there. So therefore, there is always a compression is there. It cannot prevent the compression. It will come out slightly, 5 mm or 2.
Dr. Karne, thank you for a lovely presentation and an insight and inspiration for all of us to do your work. What is the longest non-union or delayed union you have treated?
1 year.
One year. And did you show that case here?
Yes.
All right. In that case, there was absorption.
Yes.
Yeah. How much was the absorption of the calcar?
There was a total absorption of calcar. Small bit was there. There is a shortening. Mm-hmm. Actually, what happens? Actually, we have to bring two surfaces together. Mm. A 20 years old male or female. Suppose there is option for joint replacement, non-cemented or anything like. But if you can bring together, and then with the compensation of that shortening by abduction osteotomy, probably it gives a reasonable environment for healing as well as for future walking. Now I shall say there is some limitation of movement, there is some compromised function, but they live on, they live on.
Second part, when it comes after 1 year, is it difficult for you to make out whether that head is vascular or not? Are there any criteria you use? And third is when you have non-unions with AVN established, would you advocate this procedure?
No. Actually, we do MRI. Suppose MRI, that case also, in two cases I have shown, 1 year old, MRI did not show any AVN.
Okay.
Now it is said that even a neglected fracture, the incidence of MRI, the incidence of AVN is very, very less because of unknown reason. Where there is no, I don't know what is the reason. After internal fixation, it is much more. But suppose,
third question is not
over. Suppose if the avascular necrosis is there, the people they say that you do abduction osteotomy and probably that. But I have not tried and I don't advocate also. If there is avascular necrosis, which way it is going to work, whether it will be painful or painless, and it is better not to do the surgery and I have not done it.
Right. Before I go to Sangeet, I'll ask you just two questions, partly I think what he was trying to ask. One, I'm asking something else. How many of your procedures have failed? Okay, number one. And number two is, how many patients in these late presentations have you seen AVN on day one? You said that the literature shows the incidence is very low. What have you found in your experience?
The AVN is there. AVN is there, but I don't operate the patient, those who are having AVN.
So and how many did you see
in
of that kind?
42 patients. Only which I have 42 patients which I have seen. I have seen pre-operative AVN only in two cases.
Okay. And the failure rate?
It is 10 to 15%.
Sangeet.
Wonderful work. Now, two questions. One is, what is the role of that autogenous cancellous graft? Have you followed up what is the contribution of that graft? It is only to occupy the head, which is void, or it fills up the volume, or does it contribute to the union? Have you observed them or have you followed them for a longer time? Because we cannot make out whether it has really contributed, because you have anatomically reduced that non-union, you have fixed up with a DHS and a re-rotation screw. So what is the role of that cancellous bone, if any, as far as the union is concerned?
The void, when you fill, actually what happens, if you put a DHS screw in an osteoporotic void bone, there is every chance that it may become loose. If you put a corticolocancerous graft in that into the cavity as well as into the DHS hole, when you rotate the DHS hole inside insertion, it gives resistance and it is firmly gives the grip to the DHS screw, one. Secondly, it helps in union because I have done more than 32 cases. I have equal number as well as Dr. Chandak from Nagpur. We are both working on this project. So the results are very, very, very encouraging. Second thing, what is the contribution union? You have to find out the randomized trial, whether with and without bone graft. So I am very, now I am not very mature to give the opinion on this, whether it contributes into the union. But I feel, mere ko aisa lagta hai ki it helps in the union also.
And second question was, in some of the cases where you have done a valgus osteotomy, the valgus is not acceptable. It is beyond 160
yes.
degrees.
Yes.
And the head, part of the head, appears to be subluxated out from the socket.
Yes, sir.
So have you followed them up and what is the consequence as far as a hip function or AVN or any symptoms which are concerned?
There are three cases of AVN. Actually, I would have shown it. In due course of time, the AVN, but there are two types of AVN, I think so. You see a very bad X-ray with the follow-up in the AVN, but still the patient, they have a very little pain. And suppose other patient, you had a small segmental collapse is there, osteonecrosis is there, they are very, very painful. It is very difficult to substantiate that this avascular necrosis is going to cause the problem or this one. But I think the message is that don't be very much worried about avascular necrosis. Most of them, they are not symptomatic. And if at all there is a symptomatic, we have another method to do the job.
Sir, two questions. First is, if there is a delayed union or delayed non-union basically, there will be a fibrous tissue at the fracture site. So what is your call on that? And second thing, what is your weight-bearing protocol post-operative?
Because of compression and bone grafting and drilling, the bone dust is settled there. So that is the osteoinductive part. And you are DHS compressing it so that the whole tissue is compressed. Second thing, what is weight-bearing? After 6 weeks, weight-bearing. Till 6 weeks, if the fixation is very, very good, yeah, walking with the crutches, partial to touch weight bearing.
Sir, two questions. One has been previously discussed. What is your threshold for assessing the viability of the head from two aspects, from the age of the patient and from the duration of the fracture? What is your threshold when you like to assess the viability of the head?
Each and every neglected fracture patient, they must go for MRI scanning for this avascular necrosis. If the avascular necrosis is evident, it is better to not to perform this all these degrees because there is avascular necrosis, which way it is going to turn up, you don't know. And you are also anatomy of the proximal femur, you are disturbing. So the future surgery is a difficult problem. Therefore, if AVN is already established, I will not go for
surgery. So 22-year-old shows a little bit of AVN.
I will go for surgery.
That's what he's asking. No, what defines is,
age.
Time?
Suppose if it is a 50 years old with a avascular necrosis, I will straightway go for other mode of treatment.
Hello.
MRI. Even on the 50-year-old, will you go for MRI?
Yes, we'll go for him.
So he said for all he will do an MRI.
Sanjay, you should.
There's three people here, then you.
MRI is confusing. It will not show AVN unless the fracture unites and revascularization occurs. Then only the MRI will show. Otherwise, MRI is misleading. Please don't do it. All that you have to do is puncture it, open the thing, then see. MRI is really after union. I have an MRI, I don't do it.
AVN only after?
Union.
No. But does it show vascularity or does it not show vascularity? No, there's two different questions here. Two different questions. Dr. Tanna? The last word?
First is the MRI, as he mentioned about, will show the signs of collapse if it is healed up, because that is the sign of revascularity. But what he is talking about is the signal density which is seen in MRI, which when we see it in an early AVN or a Perthes, it is what we see. So Mukhi, what you're talking about is the collapse which occurs, because now it is the fracture which is healed up, so there is a weight bearing, and that is what you're talking about. The MRI signs of a signal changes into the epiphysis. This is what he's talking about. Now the second thing is, anyway,
suppose if you want to do a surgery, my protocol is 50 years, fracture non-union up to 1 year, we must try. After 50 years, two opinions. Whether you want to do a reconstruction surgery or replace. After 60 years, no second thought.
Gadegone, if I can say, what is the role of fibula? In the international literature, in my surgeries, I have never used a fibula there. It is only the alignment change which really gives the healing. So the fibula, whether it is of use or no, it is still query. Your osteotomy with the DHS which you are bending it, same osteotomy if it is done at the site of the insertion of the screw, you don't need that bending. You won't need that knee valgus. You won't need that any pain into the knee joint. So what you are doing it has succeeded in your hand, but I am absolutely sure if you do the osteotomy a little more proximally at the insertion of the screw, it is 100% going to succeed. Or if you do a 95, if you do a double angle 120 degree plate, and do not push the plate further up, and then you will be able to maintain that alignment so that there will be no valgus at all, and there will be knee will be spared. So these are the two things. In all the international literature, fibula is an Indian version of the surgery. I think started by in the north by Yadav and Nagi and other people, but
whatever it may be, sir, it is a bone. Suppose if you put a derotation screw, instead of derotation screw, it works as a derotation screw, and it fills the gap. One second is the osteotomy, sir. That osteotomy is only possible in a condylar blade. In DHS it is not possible. Why?
We may agree to disagree.
Yeah. No, sir, DHS, because Yes, sir. But DHS, it will produce A3 type of fracture. So reverse oblique type of fracture, and there will be excessive medialization. So there should be a near about 1 centimeter gap between the screw barrel and the osteotomy side. So if you want to do osteotomy at a higher level, you need a condylar blade plate. And I am not very expert in doing condylar.
Okay, Dr. Sabnis, you'll get the mic, don't worry. Dr. Sabnis.
Dr. Gadegone, I know you have huge amount of work and you're more experienced than all of us. I just want to ask you that you say that close reduction for old fracture neck femur of any angle or any garden type, you always achieve close reduction on SIAM, because there are many times that you don't get the close reductions exactly.
मी आयुष्यात कधीच ओपन रिडक्शन केलं नाही.
Why? Because I am referring to two papers before these replacements for us was very, very one I remember in a Wyrock, before Ingal Harikar turned to spine, he had presented the anterior approach Smith Patterson and open reduction, fixation, and anteriorly going down, opening the capsule and putting bone grafts. And similarly, a paper from Dr. Dheer's unit, when I just left that unit, multiple, Ashit Rao was his lecturer, assistant or he used to put multiple Austin Murpins with bone grafting from anterior side. I remember these two. Now, what is your opinion about this anterior bone grafting after opening the capsule rather than putting through?
No, mala experience na sir. Sir, case hai which will solve all the problem.
Always opens. All from the AO, always open. You reduce your US does open, even if it is possible to reduce, he says you will get a better reduction by opening, and that is his view. I agree with your view, and I tell you that MRI is a fallacy, it confuses you, and fibula makes your total hip difficult.
But sir, you
it puts your stem into varus.
Anywhere, if it is a bone graft, we have to push it, pack it. It will go. It fill up the gap. It will go posterior support.
Support. The posterior medial aspect.
It will not.
Stay down below. Then you, it is not accessible to you.
It will go.
No, it will not go.
Doctor.
The fibula will not migrate out. As it collapses, it doesn't migrate out.
Collapse.
It doesn't allow the collapse.
It will not allow the collapse.
That's exactly.
Doctor Gadegone. All patients who have got fracture neck femur have got these displaced, have got disruption of the ascending branch of the medial circumflex artery. Therefore, whether they come on the day one or they are displaced or they are coming after 3 months or 6 months, they are avascular. Now, the radiological changes of avascular necrosis, the depression and the V sign and all that will occur only after it is united or after osteosynthesis. So therefore, all head of femur which are broken are avascular. So there is no need to do an MRI. That is one. The second thing is that you have done an abduction osteotomy and you have got a good result. But you have bent the plate. My suggestion is you pass a guide wire at 110 degrees or 100 degrees. Do an abduction osteotomy intertrochanteric level and put a 140 or 135 degrees DHS. You put the screw at that angle of 100 or 110, and you do an abduction osteotomy and put the femur to the plate using a 135 degrees barrel plate.
No problem.
So you can do that instead of bending.
No problem.
And therefore, no, one more thing, that your osteotomy is far below where the problem is. Now, if you see the principles of drawer pelle, you have to be close to the deformity, and the deformity is the neck of femur. Now, you have done that, you have got good results. That's not the question. The question is, you don't have
You can't argue against a good result, of course.
Yeah. So, you have got a good result, but can you do that? You try to pass at 100, 110.
Oh, that is there. That
and put
I have tried all methods.
Huh.
I have tried all methods and I have a collection of more than 100 cases of osteotomy with various varieties, various.
Huh.
Angle blade, DHS, then double angle blade. There are so many. There is a variety of cases. It's a time constraint. But I will show you a wonderful case if you are, if permits.
Now, after you can speak to him, discuss it at the break. We need a break because you all need to build up your energy to question Sangeet, who is going to speak after this. Yeah?